Russian cocky. Call me. I walk up in demons, spend 10K just like it's nothing. I hang with the demons, they don't play by me, we cut. I was coolin', I Atlanta. Mixed the with the fan up. I got Santa. I go monkey. Hop that.
Sacrifices.
I
so many sacrifices.
Straight up.
I done gave up so much free time, knowing time ain't free.
Free.
I sacrificed it.
Sacrifice.
My girl showed me love, she know I made sacrifices.
Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Opening week in the NFL is an exciting time for everybody, including these two teams here today. It's the 49ers going up against the Seahawks.
All right, Larry, somewhat surprisingly, the rain has held off, just overcast skies so far as you get a look inside CenturyLink Field in Seattle. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the San Francisco 49ers and the Seattle Seahawks. Yardage right off the bat here as he's up to about the 24-yard line. Second down and four. Here's Wilson. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. Together here from the D-line. They run with Perry, and not much there at all. Maybe a yard up to the 43.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Out of the gun. Here's Wilson. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And a big hit at the end of that one. He's knocked down hard at the 49. Two yards to go here on third down. This is the Oklahoma State alum, Chris Carson. And he'll get this into enemy territory, but not by much, as he's down to the 48. Give him a yard on the play, and he's definitely short. It'll be fourth down in a few inches. And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on fourth. They run for it with Carson. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line. A big hitter there. A first down gain of 26 yards.
Ooh, that's taking a real chance on the opening drive of the ball game. I get wanting to be aggressive, but you don't want to leave your defense in a bad spot right away. Fortunately, they're able to convert here on fourth down.
And here comes play number 6 on this drive. Carson, and able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. 5 yards on the carry, good pickup on first down.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. You'll take that anytime you hand the ball to a back.
And the defense with their backs against the wall a little bit here as the offense is in the red zone. Now they'll throw it with Wilson. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Eric Armstead. He's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9. Wilson of the Seahawks looking for something big following the sack. It's third and long here. From the gun, it's Wilson. And some room to work. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. In the red zone this time. Now it's Carson. And he is is in for the Seattle touchdown. A great effort there, taking it in from 7 yards away. And the Seahawks take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. No going for two. They'll kick the point after. And this will give the Seahawks a 7-0 lead. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been had he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. Time with Devontae Freeman. And not a whole lot doing there, so he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. A gain of 3, second down.
Partner, you know I love to point out when teams break tendency and do something a little bit different from the norm. But when you run the ball in the first play of the drive, that's not a tendency breaker at all. That's just trying to establish yourself as you move forward.
And the wideout in motion. Snap comes at 1. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off at about the 31. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line.
Well, this is a defense that can confuse even the best of quarterbacks with their zone schemes. And here you've got a linebacker that's going to stay at home and just sit down in that zone. And this one basically comes right to him.
And a great spot to start this drive from here. They'll run it now out of the gun. And room there to work it inside the 25. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1. Getting the sense, Charles, they're going to put a big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not? What we're seeing so far, working pretty well from them. And here's the best part. We always talk about the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes natural light best.
Alongside my broadcast partner, Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon hits the Seahawks with a football to begin quarter number 2. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there, but it's enough to give him a new set of downs.
2nd and 1, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there, pick up the first down.
Again with Carson. And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
And that's why you see a lot of teams that like to play 4-3 defense, especially against teams that run the ball really well, because you count on your defensive front, the tackles and the ends, to eat up the blocking in the offensive line and keep that guy in the middle clean so he can roam through the football and make a tackle. In this case, he introduced himself and said, "Hello, my name is Mike."
Go, go, go.
Now Wilson on second down. That is caught at the 7. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. It's a really nice 15-yard pickup, and now it's first and goal. With Carson, and he will take this one in for the Seattle touchdown. A great play there. Already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Seahawks add on to their lead. Now the extra point. And it's good to make it 14-0. Kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. Already down 2 touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down 2 touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything. At least 3 points get that 0 off the board. He'll wind up getting right about 4 there on the scramble, and it's second down.
Now, how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
Second down. They'll set up the screen for Freeman, and he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. And hang on here, Freeman shaken up, remaining on the ground after that last play. Huh, hate to see this. Week 1 of the season. We'll be back. Third down now following the completed pass. Shotgun now for Rodgers. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked up by the all-pro free safety, Earl Thomas. And the return here is stopped at the 35-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
And they'll start this drive with very good field position. This is Carson. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up 2nd and 5.
Partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got 5 here. They've got to feel pretty good about that one.
And with the play clock reading 4, we're going to get a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter.
This is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
To play here in the first half. Back to CenturyLink Field after this. And the offense lining up first and 10. Wilson. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And they're going to lose some on this play, being knocked back to the 18.
You know what the key to a good screen pass is, don't you?
But you're going to tell me, good blocking?
Well, good blocking eventually, but first it's good acting. You want to let the defenders go past you, leak out to whichever side or even in the middle where you want to set up the screen, and then you do your blocking. How about the read, though, by the defensive guys? They weren't fooled at all and actually ran with the lineman to where the play was and smothered it for a loss of yardage.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. And now the 49ers signal for a timeout defensively. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. Third and 11, and some extra depth to the secondary here. They're in the dime. They'll run it now out of the gun. And they're going to lose some on this play, being knocked back to the 18. And the 49ers going to take another timeout. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. So on fourth down here, Mike Tomlin says, let's just get 3. From the right hash, it's a 35-yard attempt. And he pulled it. Oh, my goodness. It's no good. He missed it. And this score will stay right where it is. So a bullet dodge there defensively. They surrender excellent field position on the kick return, but it winds up not costing him a thing.
And that's a tough sequence of events from an offensive perspective. The inability to get first downs leads to the field goal try. And the inability to cash that in leads to nothing on the scoreboard.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Got his target, Pierre Garçon. And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line. Throwing on first down is Rodgers. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. Now before this second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Rodgers to throw on second down. And Rodgers intercepted a third time. Picked off at the 25.
You hear me laughing, partner, and I'm not laughing at the situation, but sometimes you just get yourself into a rut
It's hard to shake yourself out of it.
And the Seahawks get ready to trot out on the field. And they have to feel like they missed on an opportunity for points last time when they couldn't connect on that short field goal try.
And no doubt about it, because they were counting on those points. In today's NFL, let's face it, that's really a chip shot, right?
That's anything inside 40.
Yeah, they're counting on that going through the post. But we've seen it happen to teams before. Some of the best kickers in the world can miss kicks like that. Can they come back now and redeem themselves?
After the interception, here's Wilson. And this is going to be caught, but they'll say out of bounds. So it's incomplete.
Out routes are always timing routes. And if the timing's off just a little bit, it can really throw off a play. It looked like he led him a little too much there.
Yeah, there was a fraction of a second because he caught it, just couldn't stay in bounds. So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 45. Give him four on the ground there. They're now left with third and 6.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get them into a manageable third down, because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
On third down, Wilson. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. First down, Seahawks, Wilson to Baldwin. He's been the forgotten man in this first half. Not a guy you want to forget. Not only his first catch, first time they've targeted him.
That doesn't make any sense, does it?
Not at all.
Because those are the types of plays that he provides. When he does come alive, when they do look his way, not only is it a big catch, it's a first down.
And they line up now for what will likely be the last play of the first half. Final play of the half, it's Wilson. He's going to air this out for Baldwin. And this one is incomplete. So we've reached halftime here on opening weekend, as we will send you eastward to Orlando and Larry Ridley. He's standing by with our EA Sports halftime report. Take it away, Larry. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. Here comes the 49ers offensive unit, as they'll have it first to begin this third quarter. They come out here with a zero on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there, because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset, but typically halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that. And in this case, are they upset that the plays weren't working because of execution? Or did they think just they were just bad plays to call?
Yeah.
We'll find out pretty quickly here if they feel like they had something going, but they just need to do it a little bit better or not.
We'll find out. And on second and 10 now. Shotgun now for Rodgers. And he's able to get this one up to his 30 before he's out of bounds. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
If you're running out route, it's likely you're going to end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
Completed pass on second down. Now it's third down as the defense looks for the stop.
Easy.
Working from the gun, Rodgers. Oh, he almost intercepted it. They're just forcing it into too many tough spots. That was almost a fourth pick of the game. And now fourth down. Thank you. NFL teams last year, a little under 50% on fourth down conversions. This is a bit tougher. Fourth and four. They do go for it. It's Rodgers. And it is incomplete. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Seahawks, they'll get the football back in outstanding field position. Now we'll see what this Seahawks offense has in store with their... First possession of the second half. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? They score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, you feel like you can take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
It's still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
Perry. And he'll be taken down just shy of the red zone at the 21. 9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a second and one.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
See if they stay on the ground for second down. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. On second down, Wilson. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
That would have been a great catch, but it was real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he had been able to haul that one in.
The Seahawks on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. They're up against a third and one situation. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. The Seahawks on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. They need just a yard here. It's third and one. And he will have the first before he's brought down right on the chalk of the 20. He needed a yard, that's what he got, and it's going to earn him a new set of downs. So the offense has it first and 10. Carry heading left, and he'll at least get him inside the red zone here, down to about the 19. Nine yards still remaining here to pick up the first on second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. He's dropped just inside the 20. A little second effort there, but couldn't find a whole lot of space. Back-to-back one-yard runs here, so that leaves him with a third down and 8. And the defense searches for one more stop here after the run on second down. Right. Wilson to throw on third down. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
That's a first down if he holds on, but you saw the contact, able to jar it free from him and force a fourth down.
Great play defensively there, as you said, just to knock it free, because if he had caught that, pass the sticks, first down. Oh, this ball hangs out to the right. It's no good, and this score will stay right where it is. Well, it's still a good-sized lead, so they haven't necessarily needed him, but this is now two missed field goals for him in this game so far.
Yeah, and the question now is, will he be prepared when they do need him? Whether that's later in this game or sometime down the line, having a kicker you can count on is definitely imperative.
Oh, he tried to pitch it, and the ball's loose. Or call it luck or skill, whatever the case is, they're feeling good about just keeping the football there.
Yeah, the biggest thing that they're calling it now, our ball. I mean, they don't care if it was luck or skill. Boy, the panic that jumps up in your chest when that ball's on the ground, whether you get it or your teammate gets it, just as long as you maintain possession, that's all you're looking for.
A near turnover, but the offense recovers it. Now they'll try to regroup on second. Here's Rodgers to throw. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off near the 32. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line.
All right, Brandon. Normally when you hear about guys making two interceptions in the game, you're thinking, must be a free safety, maybe a corner. How about getting two picks out of one of your linebackers? Again, he's just in the right place at the right time. And that's another great play to come away with the football.
A handoff as they run the counter play. Space to run past the 20. And he will score. Touchdown, Seattle. A great effort there with his first career touchdown in his first career game. And the interception by the Seahawks D leads to a touchdown. The call is to go for one and kick the extra point. Is now 21 to nothing. The kickoff unit is out on the field and they will send this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers. Deep ball for Goodwin. And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. You're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time. Rodgers will try again on second down. They go screen pass to Hyde. And he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Only a yard there. Sniffed out well defensively, and it brings up third. Rodgers on third down. And the Seahawk defense gets to him, and they bring him down. Jaron Reed coming in to drop him for a loss of 8, and it'll be fourth down. Here's Colton Schmidt now as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Fielded just inside the 30. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And it'll be Seahawk football, first and 10. The Seahawks offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. They had the double-digit lead at halftime, and they have continued to roll. They're hard to stop right now.
I think what we're seeing is an example of a team that has it figured out in this ballgame. And whatever the adjustments are the defense has made, hasn't fazed them at all. They either anticipated them, or they've been so far ahead that they just can't catch up.
Now it's just a search to add to the lead. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll take this up over the 40 to about the 41. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out. But a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. Just a 1-yard pickup there, and it's going to make it 3rd down at 6.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
Back now in Seattle, Washington. The Seahawks on 3rd down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This will be 3rd and 6. Play clock winding down. Now Wilson on 3rd down. And he's got the 1st down yardage before being taken down at midfield. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going to
ask you, that wasn't the primary target. He's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, ah, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. It'll be a loss of 1, and that's going to lead to a 3rd and 11. Throw is Wilson, and he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charles, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead because you keep flinging it around, you throw a couple of picks, you can put yourself in jeopardy.
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. Oh, boy, he fielded it right on the goal line. Great blocking, nearly sprung him there. 28-yard return. And the Niners will go on offense, first and 10. Start the drive with Hyde. Looking to find a lane, but he can't. Reined in at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. And this defense continues to give them fits. They just can't get really anything going on the ground, can they?
I love the theme that you just brought up. This defense has been tough all game long against the run. We just saw another example of it there.
Yards. They take him down at the 26. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and that's going to lead to a third and 12. Now Rodgers on the bootleg. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by the Pro Bowl safety, Cam Chancellor. And he's able to get it back to right around the 27. The interception woes, they just continue to mount. He's thrown five picks. At this point, you got to be thinking, is it something between the ears?
I think a confidence hit does occur once you start getting those numbers up there a little bit. But as you and I both know, it's not always just one guy's fault. Maybe somebody ran a wrong pattern. Maybe some balls were tipped. It could be so many different things. Bottom line, though, it comes back to the guy throwing them.
And what do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all three still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the two-minute warning. Time running out here on the play clock. A handoff as they run the counter play. And he is knocked down from the side. Time for a break. We'll come back and wrap up garbage time after this. The Seahawks on third down. They're at 50%, 4 for 8. This is third and 8. From the shotgun, Wilson. End zone caught. Touchdown, Seattle. Doug Baldwin, 25 yards for the touchdown. And the Seahawks capitalize on the short field as they take it in for 6. It's good, and they stretch their lead to 28-0 now. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And San Francisco gets set to go here. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride?
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. Try to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden the secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
So second and 10 here. To throw again. Rodgers. Over the middle to Garcon. Pass the 20. 10. Touchdown. 49ers. Pierre Garcon. His first touchdown as a 49er. And the 49ers make some inroads here on that deficit. So they will get on the scoreboard here. Give them credit for that. Too little, too late, but no zero. Are you kidding? You're going slow clap on me.
Not very nice, is it?
No, but they haven't been very nice on offense. It's been a struggle. Now here's Suckabout to kick it away. Let's field it a few yards into the end zone. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. The Seahawks offense now, they get ready to come back onto the field. They have the big lead here late. They protected their home turf well, didn't they?
They certainly did, partner. And just think about how good that feels, because every team has a goal when they start the year to win at home. All right, and sometimes you don't win all of them, but they managed to get that done today. Just think about, your routine stays the same. Everything's familiar. You feel right going into the game, and they translated that into a win.
They did indeed. They protected the home field, and now the final stages. So the run moves the chains, and here we go on first down. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. Now a handoff here to his running back, and he stopped immediately there. And now the 49ers signal for a timeout defensively. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Ten yards still left on second down. They'll toss it out to Carson. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. And the 49ers going to take another timeout. That'll be their second, so one more chance to stop the clock here, and we'll be back. And the Seahawks on third down, 5 out of 9 thus far. This is third and 10. Here's Wilson. From the gun, he'll throw. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he's got a first down as he's up to the 48. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
Good route, good pickup for first down yardage. And that is a tough one to cover, the angle route, because a running back getting out of the backfield, if you're trying to cover that, especially if you're in the linebacker spot and you're seeing this play develop, he heads out towards the flat first, and that often gets you to overcommit running in that direction. Then he cuts back up inside you into the middle of the field. That's what we just saw there for a nice pickup.
Clock counting down toward 40 seconds as they take the knee. And partner, this first week, this first game that we get to call together, so special every year, week one. You had the flyover, the big American flag out there before the game, all the hoopla, just having football back, so special.
It is an opening day, opening game. There's just nothing like it because you really build to a crescendo. But the best part for us is that crescendo lasts for a while. Opening game here, an entire season. We get into the playoffs, to the Super Bowl. I was really excited. I could barely sleep last night. I can't imagine being a player.
So for the Seahawks, that'll be a happy locker room as they start the season 1-0. And they'll hit the road next week to take on the Arizona Cardinals. Meanwhile, for the Niners, they go down to defeat here in the opener. And they will get a home date next week as they will take on the Dallas Cowboys. So that'll do it for my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughan. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. It's a win for the Seahawks here as we say so long from Seattle.
Too fast to prepare for this. Tripping in the world could be dangerous. Everybody circling as vultures. Negative, nepotist. Everybody waiting for the fall of man. Everybody praying for the end of times. Everybody hoping they could be the one. I was born to run, I was born for this.
Whip, whip. Hanging on to the visual, I wanna be invisible. Looking at my ears like I'm out of dumb. Everybody needs to be a part of them. Never be enough on the prodigal son. I was born to run, I was born for this.
Whip, whip, run me like a racehorse. Pull me like a ripcord. Break me down and build me up. I wanna be the slip, slip. Word upon your lip, lip. Better that you rip, rip. Break me down and build me up. Whatever it takes.
Parenthetical, hypothetical, working out of something that I'm proud of, out of the box and epoxy to the world and the vision. I'm just a symbol to remind you that there's more to see. I'm just a product of the system, a catastrophe, and yet a masterpiece, and yet I'm half deceased. And when I am deceased, at least I go down to the grave and die happily. Leave the body of my soul to be a part of me. I'll do what it takes.
Whatever it takes.
Take me to the top, I'm ready for whatever.
Yeah. Pulling up with the crew.
Oh my goodness.
Must have done same with the roof.
Oh my goodness.
You sitting looking stupid on the stoop.
Oh my goodness.
I would take notes if I were you.
Oh my goodness.
This was designed with the stars, the square and the cross, so we know true north.
Oh my goodness.
Smiling with 50 carats in my jaw.
Oh my goodness.
The law. It's a shame. Rhyme. It's a shame they let us jump out of Bentleys with dirty vans. Hit the stage for 15 minutes, get 30 bands. Swiss bank counting clean money with dirty hands. With some hood that's ready to with the. Since I came in, it made my name a name brand. French. Paris clubbing like a caveman. We threw up the pyramids, now they say we Illuminati. I'm a tsunami, what the f*** is a Lil Yachty? No blood diamonds, I rock gold like a king. Jewelry so cold, made them blow the nose off the Sphinx. You think I'ma be some type of role model? I go full throttle, desperado, that's the motto. Vic in Chicago, it's Hugh Hef at the grotto. Brazilian motto, she mean mugging like Frida Kahlo. Drinking it with an Alicia Machado. I'm the ticket, you just hit the lotto. Pulling up with the crew.
Oh my goodness.
Must have done same with the roof.
Oh my goodness.
You sitting looking stupid on the stoop.